Look up from your telescope, take me on this journey home. I don't wanna wait no more. Lay me down behind the moon, tell me you'll be on real soon. I don't wanna wait no more. We could be dancing in the stars, we could be floating all the way. As long as I'm safely in your arms, and it don't really matter where we stay. Don't last, babe. Space makes me sad. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Mark. Some of my friends call me Marke, and I'm a going final year business student studying at the National University of Singapore. So if you've been around the channel for a while, you will know that I'm trying to post frequently and trying to push out more weekly content. But I think I'm already slowing down in terms of video content, and the large reason is because I have been interning over the summer. Well, I can't really say where I've been working over the last 2 months. I have been on the product team at a payments company doing marketing and strategy as an intern. I guess you can call this a week in my life as a marketing intern, or even just a recap of my entire internship. This internship has been quite different for me, and because it's my last week at the company, there's going to be a lot of final presentations and meetings that I'm going on, so I thought I'd just bring you guys along my last week as an intern at a payments company. So let me pull on my ASMR mic. Let's go. At the start of my internship, my company sent me a work laptop to my house, which had to be connected to the company's VPN and secure network. And because of that, it was a little bit restrictive in terms of my usual workflow. So for that, I used my laptop and pulled out Notion to track the things I have to do for the day. I've had many calls over the last 10 weeks at the company, and I'm glad I made sure to track my progress to help me complete my project on time. So every morning, I usually boot up both laptops and get started on work. So my project was about looking at customer data and trying to come up with strategies to improve the customer experience with the product. And I'm probably not the best at data, but computing kits please go easy on me. I think especially for marketing students, there's less opportunity to work with data. So the last time I actually used like pivot tables, for example, was about 2 years ago. I also had to speak to different teams and stakeholders like customer marketing, sales, account development and product to get their thoughts and feedback on my project. Given that it's my last week, I've been having a lot of mock presentations and reviews with my manager to prepare for my final presentation with senior leaders. I also forgot to mention that my internship was fully virtual, so I've not met any interns or colleagues in real life, so that kind of sucked. At the start of each week, I usually have a catch-up session with my manager to track the progress of my project and also plan out things I needed to do for the week. We also had a group project with some of the other interns, so at least there was a chance to interact with other uni kids despite the whole internship being virtual. For our intern project, we've been working on some recommendations for app features that could relate to youth, so it was a good opportunity to just make friends and bounce off ideas among us. Fun fact, I don't know why, but we only really started talking and getting close in like week 6. But I guess it was still fun, especially in the last few weeks. And because we were suggesting an app, we had to come up with some mockups to visualize our ideas. I took a mock in NUS Biz on design thinking last semester, so that gave me some opportunity to pick up Figma, which kind of worked out for my internship. So Wednesday was my presentation day, and I had both my own project sharing and intern presentation that was going on, so that was pretty intense. I got into my formal work from home attire and started my morning with my own individual presentation first. I think there were like over 20 people on the call with some senior leaders. I remember I had many versions of my slide deck to make sure that it was clear for everyone to understand. I then took a quick lunch break before preparing for the next presentation with the other interns. We had a quick run through of our presentation flow before we presented to another set of senior leaders and the campus recruitment team. And it was really nice because all of us were supporting each other. It was a good working experience with the other interns, and we're hoping to all meet in person once there are less restrictions. You may be thinking, wow, a virtual internship is probably quite hard to manage because you're pretty much alone at home, which is true, but I think I got pretty used to it and have a lot more flexibility in my time, especially because I'm managing my own project. So let me tell you the more interesting things you can do during a virtual internship if your company allows for it. Firstly, if you're lucky, the company may have some fun activities for you to join to de-stress. I've been on a couple of virtual events, including a Hari Raya event which included a trivia game. I'm not the best at trivia, but the organizers said we were free to use Google whenever we wanted. And because students are quite well known for being good at Googling anything, I ended up winning the trivia among a huge group of full-timers, so that was a bit embarrassing. During your internship, you may also get some welfare or swag, which is also known as company merchandise. On top of some swag that my manager and the campus recruitment team sent, I got quite a few GrabFood vouchers across my 10 weeks for things like Colleague Appreciation Day. My fam has been ordering food on the weekends given the heightened alert restrictions back then, so that comes in handy. I also had a team bonding event where we played a round of virtual escape room with an external vendor
and it was actually pretty cool. It was under the Fun Empire and we had a bomb-ticking theme. I'm a super competitive person, so I was all over the place trying to find out the clues, and we did actually manage to win it in time.
But definitely encourage you guys to go try it out with your friends, or if your intern company needs some team bonding ideas.
For some of the bigger companies, you may have more atas events like cocktail making or a live cooking demo session. My dad just had one this week, and apart from the free drinks that the company sent over, it was pretty entertaining to watch my dad interact with his colleagues with this kind of events. I guess companies have also gotten better at this whole work from home situation too.
I think lastly, I also wanted to say that having a good manager is very important. A big part of why my internship went well, despite it being virtual, is because I had a very supportive manager and team that really pushed me. And as an intern, you just want to be able to learn and give back whenever you can. So having a good company and manager really makes a difference. So maybe consider this when you're finding your next intern, because for me, that's how all my internships have gone well so far. So that kind of sums up my last week or internship as a whole. Especially for students, it's quite important to get some internships during your uni to boost your resume and experiences. But I think I'm also glad that this internship has been rewarding and fun. Sometimes after work, I also go and try and run, especially because there's a new open space that just opened up nearby my house. But this week, I took my second vaccination jab, so I'm not gonna risk it by exercising. So I'm just gonna show you a couple of old clips that I took back then when I was exploring the area. So thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions about my internship or want me to cover more of this sort of thing, do feel free to drop a comment down below. So do like, share and subscribe if you'd like to see more content, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
Woke up, it's 2021. I wanna get texts, but I never wanna text back. Fuck, man, I'm 2020 done. Another paycheck and I blew it, but I'm still sad. We talk all of the time, but it still feels like I'm just a voice on the line. So, if you wanna come over, watch friends and then get high. Use my phone as a coaster. We'll travel back in time. Lights on the ceiling, more than a feeling. If you wanna come over, act like it's 1999. Do you mind if I'm nostalgic? Let's go back before 2000. Back before love was so distracted. I wish the boy took care of it. Time.